Public Affairs Broadcasting. Special programming from Rockingham County Radio, RCRLive.com.
Hello and welcome to Community Access with a focus on Rockingham County government. How are you today? I'm Mable Scott, the Public Information Officer with Rockingham County Government, and we like to bring you exciting new news, good news about Rockingham County government. Today we are on the road. We're on the road again, and we're on the road again with one of our county commissioners, Rockingham County Commissioner Keith Duncan, and also Rockingham County business leader and civic leader, Neil Fair. And you won't believe where we are. We're out at the beautiful Shiloh Airport here in Rockingham County. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. And first, we want to welcome Commissioner Keith Duncan. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Mabel.
Before we talk about Shiloh Airport and some historical items that you're going to emphasize, just give us a little background about you, Keith Duncan. You're originally from Rockingham County?
I am. I was actually just born right through the woods from the airport.
Oh, my goodness.
In the Shiloh when I was a kid. My cousins and I actually used to ride our bicycles all the way through this property, all the way over to the Deep Springs area, and couple of times we rode all the way to Madison on the river road.
Oh boy.
We got ventures.
So this is your old stomping ground.
It is. It's where I grew up. Good. Okay. It's a great community.
Now, you also mentioned that your father was a county commissioner. And
he was a county commissioner a long time ago when I was just a kid growing up. And I used to attend a lot of the meetings with him at Wentworth at the old courthouse. That's where they used to have the meetings when he was on the board, and I sort of wished I could go back to those days a lot of times.
Did you ever think as a little kid, I'll be sitting up there one day?
Well, I always had an interest, but to be honest with you, no, probably not. I think if he was still around today, he would be proud of where I'm at.
He would be very, very proud. And he went on to do some other things, too.
He did. He was a commissioner for about 3.5 years, and then he went to the NC House of Representatives and then over into the North Carolina Senate for about 10 years.
Okay. So Rockingham County is really in your blood.
It is. Like I said, I was born and raised here.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of great people. It's a good, everybody pulls together when people are in need, mm-hmm, and help each other out. And it's a good place to raise your family, your children, and it's just so many great people here. It's what makes our county great.
Yes. Our tagline, you're in a good place in Rockingham,
exactly,
County. So why don't you share with us just a little bit about Shiloh Airport?
Well, Shiloh Airport has been here a long time. And I happen to know for a fact the airport was built for an economic tool for our county for the future. I know there may be some people that don't agree with me. It takes money to operate this airport like it,
yes,
does anything. But
mm-hmm,
for us to be a county without an airport, I think would be probably disastrous for us because, we work so hard here trying to recruit industry for our citizens so, mm-hmm, they can have a job if they choose to work here.
Mm-hmm.
And if we didn't have this airport if people had to fly into Greensboro to come and look, I'll drive 35, 40 miles to look at a site or an,
mm-hmm,
existing building for expansion of business. First of all, I think that's a strike against you. And because since we have, I know for a fact that our airport's used a lot by the corporate aircraft, bringing people in at different times to look at property, buildings. And we're lucky that we can have this available. And also, in emergency situations, I know when the tornado in 1988 came through Stoneville,
mm-hmm,
the airport was very important. 98
mm-hmm,
was very important because we used it as a command center.
Okay.
And everybody assembled right outside the doors here,
mm-hmm,
the day after the tornado so we could get everybody on the same page so we could get our citizens assistance from the government,
mm-hmm,
through aid and assess the damage, and it was used to transport people and goods in and out.
Mm-hmm.
And, we're lucky that we've had people that's been interested in the airport, and I know Neil's here today, and we're lucky to have Neil and what he's done for this airport. So many other people like Sam Coates and Dr. Woodard over the years. It's just like I said, that's what our county's made up of.
And you know, one of my colleagues at work at county government heard me talking about we were coming out to Shiloh, and this person told me as a kid that their father would be coming out here all the time in order to go and do business for the company that he worked for. So this was just a natural thing. As we use our cars to get around, or buses, many corporate people, as you say, they need this airport.
That's true, too. And also, you know, I actually went to school with a guy, it's a friend of mine, and he learned to fly here at Shiloh. And he is presently close to retirement. I think he's close to retirement, flying commercial airliners.
Oh, my goodness.
His career was made up flying for U.S. Airways.
And it started right here.
Started right here at Shiloh.
Started right here.
A lot of people have learned to fly here.
Yeah. Well, tell us about your involvement here at Shiloh.
Well, as a commissioner, one of my goals has always been to make sure that we try to help the airport. Because like I said earlier, we have people that volunteer their time when they could be something else, but they care about the future of our county, trying to make things work, trying to assist them and helping them achieve the goals they want to do here at the airport. And we can do that through financial resources. And like I said earlier, to me, this is an economic tool. And I really think for the first time in many years that Rockingham County is starting to turn in a good, positive direction. I know we are on the economic front with all the jobs that we have available right now in Rockingham County, that employers are having a hard time finding people to fill those positions. And that's what I've been looking for about 25 years since I've been involved in leadership.
So tell us why we're here as far as the connection with you and what you're going to tell us about the historical connection.
Well, as you mentioned earlier, I attended the meetings at a very young age with my father. And at that time, our county manager was Archie Daniels. And he was a very unique individual. I can still remember seeing him just like it was yesterday at the meetings. You know, it's a lot of history with him through his father. His father's name was John T. Daniels from Kitty Hawk. And he worked for the life saving station there at Kitty Hawk. And as we all know, that the Wright brothers' first flight was there. And they had chose that area because of the terrain and the wind currents were suitable for, you know, trying to get an airplane to lift off the ground, and all the studies they had done, that was a perfect place. So they go to Kitty Hawk, I think it was 1903, for the first flight.
December 17.
And then Mr. Daniels' father worked for the life-saving station there at Manio. And, of course, I know everybody knew what was getting ready to take place. So when the Wright brothers arrived, Orville Wright asked John Daniels to take the picture of flight, the original photograph. The man had never saw a camera before in his life. It was Orville Wright's camera. He bought it with him. And he was, based on what I've read, been told, he was very nervous and didn't really know how to operate him. He just basically told him how to take the picture. And on that day, there was four flights, and three of them were recorded by photographs. And the gentleman that used to, of course, Mr. Daniels, Archie Daniels at that time was only like 3 years old. But a lot of the locals were there, including him. A lot of the families were there. So he was present for the first flight.
Oh, my goodness.
And he was county manager right here in Rockingham County. A lot of people don't really know that. And I've known it for a long time, since I was a child. And it's just amazing the kind of history you have around you and you don't know it.
So here we are with a direct connection to Kitty Hawk and the Wright brothers in 1903.
And another thing that's interesting about it, too, after they finished their fourth flight, the winds picked up, and it picked the plane up, and it was, they had to get some of the folks to help try to hold the plane down. And of course, Mr. Daniels helped grab the plane. Well, it flipped it upside down and destroyed the aircraft. And there was a saying that Mr. Daniels said that he survived his first aircraft and never left the ground.
And why is this important for our young people and for historians and people who live here in Rockingham County and beyond across the state to know? Why is this so important? Because his photo.
Well, I mean, I think it's important for people to get to know the people who made your county or your town.
Yes.
It's just like I live in Eden, and when I was growing up, it was Leakesville, Spray, and Draper. There's so much history in that town, you know, with the mills, Mr. Dumain, which I was, and, you know, to go back on that, Mr. Dumain quite often visited this county, and this was one community that was near and dear to his heart was Shiloh. And he also, every time he was in town, actually the church right across the street, Centenary, he usually came to the homecoming celebration there to visit with the people of the community. And he also owns a lot of property right here, probably a couple of thousand acres would be my guess right here in the Shiloh community.
That's great.
And then within Eden, the Bishop family, with what they did for the community. Luther Hodges, who was Secretary of Commerce under President Kennedy, lived in Eden.
That's big. That's huge.
I mean, it's just so much history around here. And I've read a lot about the early history here back in the 1800s. And, you know, we have several historical books that's been that people have taken their time to put together for those like myself and the younger generation. If you take time to read it, you'll find some interesting things.
So how do we get more people involved in wanting to help to promote all this good news and good historical tidbits and facts about Rockingham County?
Well, I like to be positive with my thoughts. I know sometimes it's hard to think positive, especially in the world we live in today.
Yes.
But negative thoughts never get you anywhere.
Yeah.
Our county is one of the most beautiful. I travel a lot. And I'm always ready to get back home to Rockingham County. And it's such a beautiful county with our rivers and all the trees. And, you know, I would say it's a safe place to live for the most part compared to a lot of other areas in our country. And just like I mentioned earlier, the people that live here with the good hearts that they have and the people, the bonding connection we have in our community, all the different civic organizations that work together, and they're doing it because they want to make this a better county to live in and to help people. And if you don't have those qualities, then you ought to start thinking about moving somewhere else. And we have them right here.
Four rivers and two state parks.
We do. We do.
It's gorgeous.
We have great hospitals here. We're fortunate to have those. Have the best, my opinion, the best community college in North Carolina for what all they provide. So it's just endless what we have.
How can we get more people involved on some of the boards and commissions and advisory committees?
That's a good point. We have trouble filling positions at the county on different committees. All you have to do is call a county commissioner, and we put those listings on the county website.
Yeah, we do.
And I think you have a whole lot to do with that.
We work with Pam McLean on
that. We do. And if they get on our county website and see that we have some of these positions that they can serve on, and they're very rewarding. And
just fill out a couple of lines.
They know, I know firsthand because I've served on about every committee in the county at some point in time.
Good, good. Well, we certainly want to thank Commissioner Keith Duncan for being with us today, for sharing some real good news and good history about Rockingham County government. We'll be right back where we're going to be talking with Neil Fair more about Shiloh Airport.
WLOE Eden. WMYN Mandan. Listen online all the time. RockinghamCountyRadio.com.
Welcome back. We just finished talking with County Commissioner Keith Duncan, and we're here at Shiloh Airport talking about all the good things that are happening here. To find out more, we've invited Neil Fair to join us. He is a local businessman and civic leader. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Mabel. Happy to be here.
Yes. Tell us about your involvement with Shiloh Airport.
Shiloh Airport came about in the mid-70s when the land was purchased and the airport was built and paved. I was mentioning earlier that privately that when I was a student pilot, I was flying out of Wharf Airport in Reedville, which was a grass strip, and learning to fly. And a friend of mine, which is now a NetJets pilot, that's a corporate pilot, he was flying out of Greensboro.
Okay.
And we happened to be in the same area at the same time, and he was having an emergency engine problem. So we both landed here where the runways were X'd off, so we weren't allowed to be here, but we did it anyway.
We had to check out
his problem, and then we got away before we got, you know, the engine was fine. It was just had some problem with one of the spark plugs.
Mm-hmm. So that was a big inaugural
So I could say maybe I was the first to land here. And of course, and the other gentleman was Tim Richardson, which was a Eden police officer and later a NetJets pilot.
Okay.
The airport generates over $3.8 million to the local economy.
That's
so
money.
So it is a lot of money this airport does annually.
Yeah.
And that's not just from the airport. It's from the corporate aircraft that come in, the people that live here, that work here, that maintain aircraft, the employees, the hotels, the restaurants, all generate money from this airport, from businesses and people that come in for not just for business, but for family meetings and other things. And so it's a great generator of income for Rockingham County.
I saw the sign out front. Before you can get in, there's this huge sign about economic development.
Yes, and we posted that last year, and we've got a lot of good comments from it.
Yes, because we need to tell the county.
Yes, yeah. People think this is just a boys, rich boys country club. It's not. It's a lot of people here keep their aircraft here, and they pay taxes. One corporate jet will generate as much tax as 100 homes in Rockingham County. So you can see the value that this airport has. At one point, we had three jets. Now we have one. But we have several other corporate aircraft that are turboprop, which means they use jet fuel also.
Okay.
It generates a lot of income.
Now tell us about your former role with the Airport Authority.
I've been on the Airport Authority for 9 years. I was 3 years as vice chairman, and the last 3.5 years I've been chairman of the board. I cycled off at July 1. After 9 years, and take a little break and let some of the other guys. Our vice chairman now is chairman until the elections every year. I enjoyed being on the airport board. We've done a lot for the airport. We've had to revamp a lot of things. Our expenses are high. Our budget is about $500,000 a year. We get $150,000 from the state and local government, well, state government and the FAA, which is, this money is generated by the sale of fuel nationwide. So that's where all that money comes. It's not taxpayers' money.
Okay.
This is money that's generated from the sale of aviation fuel, and it's given to general aviation airports.
Now, what does the Airport Authority do?
The Airport Authority is an entity into itself in the county government where it is run. Their members are appointed by the county commissioners and to serve 3-year terms each. It was started by the state of North Carolina. Each county could have an airport. The general aviation airports are FAA funded and county funded. Now, the county gives us at this point about $75,000 a year for our operating budget. The other $150,000 that we get a year comes from the FAA and state that can be only used for infrastructure like runway, taxiway, hangars to build, but cannot be used for any other items in like the general running of the business.
Okay. So as a business person and as a civic leader, Shiloh Airport is important to Rockingham County because?
Well, because you take a CEO that wants to relocate his industry or his business. He wants to arrive at the front door, and he's not going to come by train, and he's not going to come by car or bus. He is going to arrive by corporate aircraft. And we're lucky in Rockingham County to have, in three counties across North Carolina, the top part, we're the only one that's large enough, a general aviation airport. We got the longest runway, 5,200 feet. and excluding Danville, Greensboro, mm-hmm. and Winston-Salem, but mm-hmm. we have large enough to handle a lot of big aircraft, 15-passenger to 20-passenger mm-hmm. corporate aircraft. And I always tell folks that you can have 1 mile of road and all you've got is a road, but if you've got 1 mile of runway, you've got access to the world.
Right. You're right. International.
Yes.
That's important. So when you look about and think about all of this, how can we best communicate to all of the citizens here why this is so important? Well, so they can really understand.
Yeah, it's important in the fact that our airport, as we just said, generates a lot mm-hmm. of money for the mm-hmm. for the county. Of course, it takes a lot of money to run an airport.
Yeah.
We can't fund it by ourselves, so yeah. we have to have outside mm-hmm. funds coming in.
But $3.8 million is
yeah,
a lot
of
money.
Yeah, it goes back out.
Yes.
Know? And so it's a big difference there.
Mm-hmm.
The county citizens need to understand that this is their airport,
mm-hmm.
and this is their jewel in the county. We can draw in more industry. Every day we see jets come in and out of this airport or corporate aircraft. They're here to do business in our county, or they're here to look at our county. As Keith Duncan had mentioned earlier, the fact that they want to come in and look at some property to buy, they can come right here and not have to go in by commercial airlines where they're going to spend an hour getting to the airport.
Wasting time.
Waiting an hour mm-hmm. to get on board and then flying, then coming mm-hmm. another hour to get mm-hmm. here, or 45 minutes.
Yeah. For somebody like that, time is money.
Right. They can come here and turn around and go back. I fly out of here. I have an aircraft. My daughter lives in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
I can be there in less than 2 hours. I can mm-hmm. be there in 2 hours, a little over. If I had to do that commercially, that would be a 4 or 5 hour yeah. trip just to get down there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, time you do go to the airport, get on the aircraft,
mm-hmm.
may even have to do a connection in Charlotte if it's not direct. So it can be an all-day trip, but I can go down and come back, you know, drop something off to her.
And what about people who may be interested in learning how to fly?
We have several instructors. They're not there. Some are based here, but the main ones are based out of Greensboro, and they use our airport as a training airport.
Mm-hmm.
They actually we see them come from up in Virginia, from Lynchburg, to bring their pilots down here to train.
Mm-hmm.
And we are happy to say we have an airline here. No one knows that really, but it's called Image Air.
Okay.
And what this is one of the largest companies. They own the Cirrus aircraft. It's a 4-passenger aircraft.
Uh-huh.
So you as a citizen in Rockingham County, you need to be somewhere in an emergency, or you're a businessman, you can hire on with this company, or you can buy in to them in a blocks, or you can just use them as a round trip on a business trip, and you can be somewhere in 2 hours instead
mm-hmm.
of 5-6 hours.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it's not cheap, but it's a 4-seater aircraft. You've got a corporate pilot or an airline pilot retired that's flying these aircraft. And they actually can take that person and two others, the two other in the back, ride for free. So you can carry three people on a business trip that maybe you can't own a corporate jet. This is your airline.
Yes.
Or you've got a child that's sick in Florida. You can hire these folks. They can get you there. And they get you a quick. They keep a couple of aircraft based out of the Greensboro Airport.
So that means that Jan Kreitz and the commissioners and Lance Metzler and all of them are just really connected to the
yes,
airport
yes.
to help bring in more business, mm-hmm. more jobs,
right.
more money to the county.
Right.
What about the future?
I see the future is going to be we're going to grow, and the government's going to spend about another $9 million on this airport in the next between 2016 and 2022, lengthening the runway, strengthening the runway, so we can get some larger aircraft to come in. We're going to see our county grow. We're losing some businesses, but we did that years ago, and then we rebuilt.
Mm-hmm.
Redundant. We can fix the problem. We just got to work together.
Mm-hmm.
And this airport is going to be one of our main tools
to help to get that economic growth just to continue
yes.
to go up,
yes.
to spiral
so,
up.
So everyone needs to be a part of it. And come out and visit this airport. It's yours. It's a county airport. It's
so
Rockingham
if people
County.
Want to
You're
come out.
You're the taxpayer,
out,
yes.
What do they need to do?
Well, they just come out and come to our wonderful FBO, which is a fixed-based operator, but we have our manager here. And we had a jamboree here 2 years ago. Boy Scouts, 300 came from all over the northern part of North Carolina,
uh-huh.
and they camped out for several days. And Honda Jet sponsored it here at our airport. Mm-hmm. They were able to spend the night camp, bivouac as we call it, mm-hmm. and they got their merit badge, aviation merit badge. We would like to do it again. We have car shows here with an air show. We've done that for about 3 years. We've got placards here that show that. Mm-hmm. We're hoping to have some more things. Air shows are, you got to be ready with Mother Nature, so you got to be careful. You mm-hmm. can spend a lot of money and nothing come off, but mm-hmm. we can still have an open house. We're mm-hmm. hoping to do that soon,
That's
too.
That's good. That's good. So any parting messages or words that you'd like to share in regards to Shiloh Airport?
I would, you know, we have our board. It's made up of seven members, as I mm-hmm. said, appointed by the commissioners. They're not paid. These are citizens.
This is volunteer.
Volunteers.
Like what Commissioner Duncan right. just mentioned.
And as my last 3.5 years as chairman, I was here maybe 2 or 3 times a week and just come up and make sure things are running right. Or mm-hmm. not, I don't want to micromanage, but mm-hmm. I just like to be around and talk to the mm-hmm. other pilots. And mm-hmm. we have a lot of things. I have to meet with the FAA or have to meet with our North Carolina DOT representative on some issues here at the airport. But I would recommend that if you're a citizen and you're concerned, be a member of this airport and come out and learn to fly. I mean, it's a great thing to do. I love to just get out and just, as I say, shake the rust off. Go out and fly around and just get all my thoughts off my business and just enjoy the day and fly off to the beach an hour and 15 minutes. And spend an afternoon and come back. We've done that many a time.
And if nothing else, come by and see your airport.
Come by and see your airport.
This is your airport here in Rockingham County. We certainly want to thank you, Mr. Fair, for being here today. And we thank Commissioner Duncan for helping us to share and to communicate the importance of this jewel. They called it a jewel, and it is a jewel. You need to come out here and see this facility. We thank Keith Duncan and Neil Fair for joining us today. We hope we provided some valuable insight about Rockingham County Shiloh Airport. We also want to thank Mike and Annette Moore, Roy Sawyers, Kim Pryor, David Wicker, and all the folks who help us to make this show part of what you see every month on your special vehicles throughout the county as far as radio and through cable TV. Thank you again for joining us on Community Accents. And remember, we have some brand new Rockingham County, We Love Rockingham County refrigerator magnets. Go to our website and learn how you can get a free one. Thank you.